What's going on, my friends? This is Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U, and today we're going to talk about different voltage systems. So when I was an apprentice, I always wondered, like, what is the whole 120, 240, 208, 277? Like, how do all of these numbers matter and where do we get them from? So starting out, you're going to come across like a lot of low voltages. You're going to come across some medium voltages, and then there's higher voltages. Now, as electricians, we call them low, medium, and high, or we say line voltage. But really, high voltage is talking about like 500,000 volts, and as an electrician, you're never going to come across that stuff. So just for what we run into in the field, typically we're talking about stuff under 1,000 volts, usually above 50 volts, unless you're talking about low voltage systems. You know, we're talking like 5 volts, 10 volts, 15 volts, 24 volts, stuff like that. So let's start out with the really low voltage stuff. You're going to come across probably 5 volts and 10 volts, maybe 15 volts DC. A lot of times in lighting control systems or energy management systems, if you're going to work in places where there's like refrigeration and there's remote monitoring, a lot of those systems work off of communication signals back and forth where they're sending like a small little 5 volt DC pulse, and that's how they're signaling some of this stuff to turn on and turn off. But it's pretty rare that you're going to come across those voltages otherwise. Another one is 12 volts. So 12 volts you're probably going to come into all the time. There's LED ballasts, drivers, they're actually called drivers, not ballasts. But there's a lot of places where you're gonna come across 12 volt power supplies. So 12 volts is a fairly common low voltage voltage that you're gonna come across. And then you got 16 volts. 16 volts, a lot of doorbell transformers are run on 16 volts or 24 volts. But that's the rest of these voltages as well. 24 volts is another really common thing that you're gonna find in a lot of LED, like, strip lighting, because you run these like LED tape, you run these strips over a really long distance, 24 volts can actually just push a lot further down the line without there being a voltage drop, and you don't have that dimming effect. So you're going to run into a lot of that in those kind of environments. 24 volts, you're probably going to run into a lot in equipment and, like, you know, large cabinets where you're running machinery. A lot of times we'll bring 240 volts or 120 volts in and then convert it down to 24 volts and run all of these small little signaling things. So it's kind of like putting a panel into something that's only 24 volts. It's like something you can pull a lot of power and distribute it to a lot of other little things. But that's pretty much it for under 50 volts. Those are the voltage systems that you're going to come across. And a lot of them are AC or DC, or some of them are both. But we'll get into the whole difference between how AC voltages and DC voltages operate in a later video. So next we're going to talk about voltages between 100 and 250 volts. This is kind of the next class of voltages that you're going to come across, and both in single phase and three phase. So in single phase, you're going to come across systems that are 120, 240. And that makes sense, right? You've got 240 volts, and when you cut it in half, you get 120 when you have a neutral present. Otherwise, everything, all the motors and machinery would just run off 240 volts. But the math makes sense how you get from 120 to 240, right? It's just cutting it in half. You're cutting your voltage in half, less pressure. But once you get into three phase, it's kind of weird because you have things like 208, and it's like, okay, well, how does 208 factor into it? So if you have three phase, there's two different kinds of three phase services. There's either a Y configuration or a delta configuration, and it's based off of what the power company supplies to a building, what's in the area. Sometimes in different factories and different buildings, you're going to have motors that require a little bit more torque, and so they're going to need a delta service rather than a Y, or something that has like a whole bunch of lighting loads specifically. It's going to do better on a Y configuration because you're going to have a neutral with it as well. So there's reasons why, and again, I'm not going to get into all that crazy stuff in this video, but I just want to break down how these voltages are derived and what they mean. So when you hear 240 and 208, kind of the same thing. Really, 240 just means that you're working with a delta configuration. The transformer that's provided is in a delta wiring configuration. And that just means that each one of the coils inside, or each one of the windings inside of that thing, are run end to end. In a Y configuration, the centers of every single one of those coils meet up. So because they're wired in that configuration, you just get a different voltage out of it when you run incoming power outcoming or outgoing power is slightly different. So just know that if you're ever wiring a place and all of the specs call for 240 volt stuff and you're reading nameplates on equipment, it's all 240, 240, 240, and you realize that your service is 208, you need to say something. You need to address that and figure that out, because that equipment is usually rated within 5 or 10% of its value. So if you overdrive or underdrive those motors, you're going to burn them up over time. And something like a $200,000 CNC machine, like, that's really, really important to know. So that's pretty much it for the 250 volt and under voltage systems. Now we get into a little bit higher voltage. This is a lot more dangerous stuff, but you're talking 277 to 600 volts. So 277 is very similar to 120 in a lower voltage situation. It's where there is a hot and a neutral. They're just at a lot higher potential. So 480 volts is the same as 240 volts, and 277 is the same as 120. So most systems that you're gonna come across that are higher voltage, you're gonna have 480, 277, or you're just gonna have 480. There is one other voltage class above that, and that's 347 and 600 volts. So same thing, 347 is just hot to neutral. It's just a really, really super powerful amount of power. And then the 600 is the line to line, where hot to hot. But that's pretty much it. That's the voltages. I'm going to go on the blackboard or the whiteboard over here and sit and kind of do some calculations so that you understand like how you're deriving. You know, some services will have 240 and 208 and get 120, and like understanding how all that works, I'm going to actually break that down for you. All right, so let's look at different windings for different transformers and sit and break down how these different voltages come out. So first we're going to look at a corner grounded delta, and that's just a delta configuration. Again, on delta, that means that each winding of this transformer, there's three windings, each one is wired end to end or in series. So with corner grounding, that means that they actually ground one corner, or where two of these meet together. So the voltage in something like this, if we're on a lower voltage system, is going to be 240 volts between each end of that winding. And it's the same for all of the windings. So you're going to have 240 between all of them. And from any point to ground, you're also going to have 240. So that's pretty easy. That makes sense, right? There's no neutral in here at all. Nothing's tapped so that you can get 120 volt load out of it. In this situation, it's corner grounded. There's only 240 volt loads that can be served with this. Another common thing that you're going to see out in the field is a center tap delta, and that just means that instead of tapping the corner where you've got two of these windings that come together, or two of these coils, you're going to tap in the center of one of them. And what that does is it gives you a halfway point. It gives you a way to split the difference of potential of one of these and have two smaller differences in potential. So you're still going to have 240 volts across all of your coils, 240 between there and there, there and there, there and there. But because we just basically cut that coil in half, or we intercepted the halfway point of it, it allows us to get 120 volts out of each side. So this is really common. You're gonna see this. A lot of like older buildings, even houses, like there's places around here in Austin, like old lake houses, that we come across this three-phase four-wire system where it has what we call a high leg or a wild leg. And it's usually one of the incoming wires that's coming up from the transformer has orange tape around it. And the reason is we have standard voltages everywhere in this system, but look what happens when we try to take voltage between this and ground. So like from here to ground, we get 120. Here to ground, we get 120. But what happens from here to ground is you get 208. Which is strange, right? Like, why? But you need to understand that that's a single phase voltage. That's for one hot to ground. You're getting 208 volts from one black wire, essentially, to neutral or to ground. And that's really dangerous. A lot of times people will hook up like lighting loads and things like that, and you'll just fry stuff because you're running 208 volts through that piece of equipment that's only rated at 120. So understanding that you have a high leg when you're working with a center tap delta is like a really crucial thing to understand. If you ever see an orange conductor in with any black, blue, or red conductors, you need to like be on alert, like, oh, this is, there's something different here and I need to be really careful. Usually that's on B phase. There's some utilities out there that likes it to be on C phase. But again, just understand what it is. It's super dangerous. So the math behind how that works and why that works, there's a number that I've talked about before, and it's the square root of 3 or 1.732. If you ever do calculations in three phase, you're trying to calculate the size of a transformer, or you're trying to figure out KVA, power factor, a lot of these different things, you have to use the square root of 3 when you're multiplying things. If you're trying to figure out single phase, you don't have to do that. But because of the ratio of these windings and how three phase operates, you have to have this extra number that we input into calculations, and it's the square root of 3, which equals 1.732. So if you ever look at voltage systems and you're looking between your line and your neutral voltage, if you multiply 120 times the square root of 3, you're going to get 208. So that's not an intended thing that happens. It's just kind of the byproduct of how this power is coming in, how the windings in that generator that's generating all of this power come together and produce voltage. So you get 208. It's the same thing if you look at a Y service. Say we've got a three-phase Y. We've got 208, between each one of our windings, we've got 208, 208, 208. And we've got 120 between each two, the center tapped ground. It's the same thing. We have 120 between each one of these, between this leg and ground, and this leg and ground. But if you take 120 times the square root of 3, you get 208. So that's just to understand how that number works. 480 volts is the same way. A lot of people that start saying like, okay, well, how the hell do you even get 277 versus 480? And if we look at it, just scratch all of these out and say this is 480, 480, and 480. Well, 277 times the square root of 3 equals 480, and it actually probably equals like 479.25 something or other, but you get the idea. And I don't just know that. That's something like you can do the inverse of it. Divide 480 divided by, you know, 1.732, you get 277. So that's where these weird numbers come from. When you see 208, 230, 240, 277, it kind of gets confusing and you're like, well, which one is what and how are we doing this? When you're actually out in the field, it's not really that difficult because you've got wires that are certain colors. If you're working with brown, yellow, and purple, or brown, orange, and yellow, depending on what municipality you're working in, you know that that's a certain voltage system and that's gonna be 480, 277. If you're working with red, black, and blue, you know that you're gonna be within, you know, the 120, 240 range, and that includes 208 as well. So hope that cleared it up. Three phase, single phase, same thing. You can still have 480 volt and 277 volt in single phase and in three phase. You can have 240, 120 in three phase and single phase. All right, I hope that helps. Let me know if you guys have any other questions. If you have like very specific things that you want to know, or if you want me to cover something a little bit better, leave a comment below. I love you crazy fuckers, and I will see you in the next one.